Hello ROS developers, welcome to the ROS in 5 minutes video series by The Construct, your channel for anything ROS. I'm Bayo Adirinola, and in this video we'll be learning about how to compile your code in ROS. For this, we are using the Robot Ignite Academy, our online academy where you find practical online ROS courses using simulated robots, no installation required. You'll find a link to the academy in the video description. For the purpose of this demonstration, we just pick any course. Let's take this. So we have two code there that we wish to run, doing practically the same thing. One written in C++ and the other written in Python. To run them, we need to compile. The first thing that we need to do is to create a package. And for that, we go ROS CD. Then we go to the SRC folder. Create a package. OB1. Then we are using ROS Py. ROS C++. Okay, great. Our package has been created. Next thing is to move our files here. The two files we want to run, we move them into the package SRC folder. And then now we want to compile. The way to compile is to run catkin make. To do that, we go back to the catkin directory and then we do catkin make. Okay, good. Our package is done building. But just to be sure, let's source the workpiece. Okay, good. So now in a new terminal, let's run our C++ program and Python program. Let's start with Python. So we can basically run ROS run. The name of the package is OB1. And then OB1 py py. So you see, this is what the code is supposed to do. So let's do a similar thing for the C++ program. Yes, for this we don't need to put the CPP. Oops, couldn't find executable name OB1 below. Wow, why? Okay, I get it now. So now, this is one difference between Python and C++ when you are using ROS. To compile properly, we still need to add some things to the CMake list to tell the build system that, hey, we have a C++ program here. So we go ahead and edit this CMake list. And what we need to add are a few lines of code here. So we need to put this in the build section. So we already have some of the same things commented out here. Or just to keep things simple, put that here. So we are adding the executable, and then we are registering the dependencies, and then the target link libraries. So we save this, and then we need to go back and run catkin make. If you notice, there's a little difference between the output of catkin make in the previous run and then in this run. You can see the here that we have the C++ file now recognized. Let's source the workspace again, and then let's go try running our C++ program. Great, it's running now. So basically that's it. In this short video, we've learned how to compile our programs in ROS. Now, the takeout from here is that it's a little bit different for a C++ file because you need to add some lines to the CMake list to tell the build system that, hey, I have some C++ source here. And so that was it. But before you go, remember to visit the link. And then when you get there, you can click this button to sign up free. And then you can do what you see in this video and a lot more. So did you like the video? If you did, please give us a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every day. Whether you like it or not, please share your thoughts and comment with us in the comments area. Peace out. Odabo.